So in this video we will discuss pens that are more than pens, so could also serve as an impact tool, especially for breaking a window, for example, to escape a car or something else. These are the pens that I want to discuss, and I will also add two more, which I will show you now. These two. To a couple ones on the top. So this would be your regular type of pen. Because it has a steel tip, it could have some possibilities also to break a window when necessary, but it will be very hard because there's little mass, and also it will easily break, especially if the window is a little bit more robust. But if it's a very weak window, so not a car window, you might have a chance, especially if you hit it at the corner. You should always hit it at the corner, because then it has the window surroundings make it more stiff, and then it can break easier. But this is just a regular pen, but with a steel tip. Then you also have another regular pen. These are regular pens, but it's quite a sturdy one and could help. But as you can see, there's no steel tip, so you should just force it then through, and it's a lot heavier than this more plastic pen, and this is more of a solid pen. So this has some benefits, but still not the benefits that one should look for if you want something extra. These little guys, as you can see here, also don't have real good possibilities for breaking a window, but if you could use these corners, perhaps you might have a chance. So also here, I'll put it like this, so you can have a close-up. You can just turn it around, and then the pen will come into vision. Now there is still a casing, but you could take this off, and then you see the pen. And of course you could try to force this through, but still not pointy. I have a similar type of pen, which is still quite heavy and still a normal pen, as I mentioned. You could also try to use this point here, where you can attach, for example, to a key or something else to force through, but still round, so quite hard to do. I will make a little bit more room and put the normal pens next to each other as well. This pen is similar to the last one that I showed, also can be here. Open by turning here. This is for the refill, so you just refill it like a normal pen. And the other side offers similar functionality, so you get there your writing area. Oh, see, here's the refill. And if you open it to the next level, that's the point. Here it is. It's quite stiff, I must say. I think I forced it once to be closed. Now it doesn't want to go reopen that easily. But I will look into that. It is the same functionality as you have in that other pen. The benefit, if you compare these two pens, is that the one with the bamboo print, so the top one, has a little bit more relief, so it gives a little bit more grip in your hand as a completely flush pen, which slides a lot easier through, as you just heard. So next on the list, So in this last video, I will also show you the copper one, the bamboo style, if you open it. So just open it like this. And then out comes the pen. It's very nice. Elegant design. Really like it. Okay, that was it for now. Have a great day. Bye bye. Would be this pen. This is already starting as a more of an escape type of pen. It has the benefit of a point here, a glass breaker point. I hope it shows. There it is. It can be removed oftentimes, and this works like a slot to release the pen, as you can see here. So I try to make this also in slow motion. So you just slide it down and then open. So you don't have to turn on anything, you can just write very easily. A similar approach has been done with these two guys, which are almost completely the same. The golden one has a removable point as a glass breaker, you can see it here. And the black one has a solid one. So first the black one, you can see it's the point as a glass breaker is part of the pen, whereas on the golden one it's an additional point. And how this works, it's very easy also to release the pen. You can open it for refills like this. The dog wants to play with the ball that's on the cabinet, and then you have your refill. As you can also see, it's quite a sturdy design. I can show it to you. Quite thick. This helps for a little bit more robust impact tool, so you can easier break glass, but you should use the other tip, as I mentioned. And if you turn it the other way around, you can open it and you have your writing area. As you can see here. Writing tip. So the black and golden one are completely interchangeable in functionality wise. This little guy looks a lot like it. And it's a little bit lighter, less robust, one could say. But it has an additional feature, which I like a lot. So you still have this glass breaker point, also removable. Then you still have the pen that can just be opened and used, as you can see here. But there's an additional benefit, and that's if you turn around to open up the glass breaker point, you can take it out, of course, and then you have a whistle. As you can see here. Which functions quite well. It can help in an emergency situation. If, for example, you broke your leg and you're lying somewhere and you just have your pen with you. Also, from the pens that I showed you, I like it when they have an attachment point. Huh? So these regular pen have this clip to attach it to, for example, your jeans or your vest or your shirt. This also has one, and all the other pens except this one has one. These two don't. They are just flush, really nice pens. There are more of art. You could attach a loophole on this flush copper one, as you can see here with my finger. The bamboo one doesn't have anything there. And then we go to the next. This pen is less easy to use because you don't have to turn it to get access to the pen. You have to really open it, like the first heavier pen I showed you earlier. So this little guy. And then on the other side, there's the glass breaker. But the benefit of this design is that you have a quite solid blades, which you could also use a little bit as a hammer. For example, if you have to hammer a nail down, or if you have to hammer this to a thicker area, then you could touch it easier. Then, for example, with this pointer, if you try to hammer that through and you will touch it here, it will hurt a lot. So that's the only additional benefit of this pen. A little bit harder to use. This little guy has all the benefits of the less pen. So you also have this hammering area, as you can see here, and this is the glass breaker, which can also be opened up. The pen can be opened up, and there you have the pen. So it's a little bit different there, whereas the black one had the glass break on one side, and you have to open the other side and then use it like that to write. But this has it more integrated. And there's an additional benefit. This pen could act as a little hammer itself. Please be aware that it is not that good of a hammer. It will just be a very small hammer. But it could help. So for example, if you have to, you take off this ring and you have a hammering area to hammer down some things. Could be handy in some situations. Also, you could use this in a tighter spot if you have to break it in a tighter spot, because you can also in that way make your glass breaker a lot shorter. This could be an additional benefit. So you could use this part to enter and or this part to hammer it down if you need to. So that gave you some insight in what I name heavier type of pens. I'll give you an overview of the total group again. So starting with a regular pen, or just a plastic pen, then also another regular pen, but a heavier one. I also like it a lot artistically. Two other heavier pens. So what I mean is, this is a steel type of pen, this is a plastic type of pen, only a small steel tip. These are like brass or copper style of pens. This gives you a little bit more grip. This has the addition of a little loophole that you could use, like also this has a ring you could use. You could even use this, for example, to put it in your hand so that it doesn't glip out, it doesn't get lost that easily. This has the easy way that you can just push that to get the pen. This one has a turning pen, so you don't have to remove anything. This has the integral glass breaker, so just a pointed tip. This tip is even more pronounced, but can be removed. This pen has all the benefits of these two, but it's a little bit lighter and also carries this little flute, as I mentioned before, the whistle. This pen has to be, the cap should be removed to write, so there could be a drawback. You also, what I like about other pens, that you could put the cap on the other side, but you see this is not possible here. But the benefits, you have a little bit of striking area that you could use. This striking area is a lot less, but it's quite a solid, strong pen. So also for harder work, this could suffice. If you open it here, you can have the ability to write still, and you could make it a smaller one and have a little bit of hammer on your small pen then, or make it a hammer form if that is easier for striking. So that gave you some insight on these pens. I hope you like it. Have a great day. Bye bye. This pen is less easy to use. Because you don't have to turn it to get access to the pen. You have to really open it, like the first heavier pen I showed you earlier. So this little guy. And then on the other side, there's the glass breaker. But the benefit of this design is that you have a quite solid blades, which you could also use a little bit as a hammer. For example, if you have to hammer a nail down, Or if you have to hammer this to a thicker area, then you could touch it easier. Then, for example, with this pointer, if you try to hammer that through and you will touch it here, it will hurt a lot. So that's the only additional benefit of this pen. A little bit harder to use. This little guy has all the benefits of the last pen. So you also have this hammering area, as you can see here, and this is the glass breaker, which can also be opened up. The pen can be opened up, and there you have the pen. So it's a little bit different there, whereas the black one had the glass break on one side, and you have to open the other side and then use it like that to write. But this has it more integrated. And there's an additional benefit. This pen could act as a little hammer itself. Please be aware that it is not that good of a hammer. It will just be a very small hammer. But it could help. So for example, if you have to, you take off this ring and you have a hammering area to hammer down some things. Could be handy in some situations. Also, you could use this in a tighter spot if you have to break it in a tighter spot, because you can also in that way make your glass breaker a lot shorter. This could be an additional benefit. So you could use this part to enter and or this part to hammer it down if you need to. So that gave you some insight in what I name heavier type of pens. I'll give you an overview of the total group again. So starting with a regular pen, or just a plastic pen, then also another regular pen, but a heavier one. I also like it a lot, artistically. Two other heavier pens. So what I mean is, this is a steel type of pen, this is a plastic type of pen, only a small steel tip. These are like brass or copper style of pens. This gives you a little bit more grip. This has the addition of a little loophole that you could use. Like also this has a ring you could use. You could even use this, for example, to put it in your hand so that it doesn't glip out. It doesn't get lost that easily. This has the easy way that you can just push that to get the pen. This one has a turning pen, so you don't have to remove anything. This has the integral glass breaker, so just a pointed tip. This tip is even more pronounced, but can be removed. This pen has all the benefits of these two, but it's a little bit lighter and also carries this little flute, as I mentioned before, the whistle. This pen has to be, the cap should be removed to write, so there could be a drawback. You also, what I like about other pens, that you could put the cap on the other side, but you see this is not possible here. But the benefits, you have a little bit of striking area that you could use. This striking area is a lot less, but it's quite a solid, strong pen. So also for harder work, this could suffice. If you open it here, you can have the ability to write still, and you could make it a smaller one and have a little bit of hammer on your small pen then, or make it a hammer form if that is easier for striking. So that gave you some insight on these pens. I hope you liked it. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Are completely interchangeable in functionality-wise. This little guy looks a lot like it. And is a little bit lighter, less robust, one could say. But it has an additional feature, which I like a lot. So you still have this glass breaker point, also removable. Then you still have the pen that can just be opened and used, as you can see here. But there's an additional benefit, and that's if you turn around to open up the glass breaker point, you can take it out, of course, and then you have a whistle. As you can see here, which functions quite well. It can help in an emergency situation. If, for example, you broke your leg and you're lying somewhere and you just have your pen with you. Also, from the pens that I showed you, I like it when they have an attachment point. So these regular pen have this clip.